Now let us see the second numerical. Draw the network diagram and identify critical path using CPM for the following activity data. Now we can see in this two rows have given and many columns are there. So in the rows activity is there and durations are there. So now the activity is given not as the alphabet, they are given as a numerical 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 3 to 5, 3 to 6, 4 to 5, 4 to 7, 5 to 8, 6 to 8, 7 to 8. Now we need to prepare the solution for this numerical. Let us start with the solution. So we are going to draw the again numerical part in this. So networking will be there, connectivity will be there. So let us start with the networking. Now 1 to 2 means it is a node activity, not arrow activity. It is a node activity. Node activity, we know that here will be 1. This is node, this is moving ahead, this is arrow. This part will be second. So similarly, we have to draw this particular network diagram. So let us start. 1 going to 2, this is second activity, that is second work whatever we have done. Now 2 to 3 and 2 to 4, two nodes are there from same preceding node number 2. So we will draw, one is 3, 1 is 4. This will be 3 node. This will be 4 node. Now again from 3 to 5 is 1 and 3 to 6 is 1. Also 4 to 5 is 1 and 4 to 7 is 1. We can see here 3 to 5 is 1 connection and 4 to 5 is 1 connection. So again they are coming back to 5th number node, so drawing that 5th number node. So 3 to 5 we have connected, now 4 to 5 we have connected. Now we will take 3 to 6, let us take it separate, that is 3 to 6 it is moving, and 4 to 7, 4 to 7 it is moving to the 7th node, this is 7th node. Now taking it ahead, let us go for next part. So up to this point we have completed. Now remaining are these three. So we can see 5 to 8 is one connection, 6 to 8 is one connection, 7 to 8 is one connection. So let us make that connection. That is 5 to 8 first connection, this is what. Then 6 to 8 the another connection. And final connection is 7 to 8. So this is how the network will be ready. Now we are going to write the duration. So from 1st to 2 the duration is 5, 2 to 3 the duration is 2, 2 to 4 the duration is 6, 3 to 5 duration is 4, and 4 to 5 duration is 2. 3 to 6 duration is 4, 4 to 7 the duration is 3, 5 to 8 the duration is 7, 6 to 8 duration is 8, and 7 to 8 duration is 2. This is what the network diagram we can draw based upon the data available in the question. Now we need to put a solution for this. The solution we have to put is we need to get the particular part of early starting time, early finishing time, late starting time and late finishing time. Also we need to show what is the maximum duration and the critical path. So let me draw the two boxes. This is the duration we are going to write in this box. So basically I made it with a separate color so that you can get a differentiation. In this two boxes we are going to write the early start duration and late start durations. So these are the all boxes on all the nodes. I am making a box for this at the downside. These are the nodes boxes, right? So let us start filling the data for this part. Means what is early start time, what is late start time in that manner. So going with particular formation. So we know this will be 0, right? So 0 plus 5, it will become as 5, correct? So now again 2 splitting. So 5 plus 2, this will be 7, and 5 plus 6, this will be 11. Agree? Now let us see. So when coming to the node number 5, I'll just take it outside. For node number 5, what are the maximum possibilities? So we are getting 7 plus 4, which is equals to 11, and 11 plus 2, which is equals to 13. So maximum one of the these two, so we are going with 13. So I am writing in this box in left side the 13. The digit is 13. 7 plus 4, here I will write 11 because it is an individual node. 4, that is 11 plus 3, it is again 14 at this point, correct? Now adding this, 11 plus 8 for this one, 3 are there. So first option, 11 plus 8, which is 19. Second option, 13 plus 7, I will write 13 plus 7, which is equals to 20. Then writing 14 plus 2, 14 plus 2 is 16. So greater of these three, it is 20, which I am going to consider, means we have to consider this is 20. Clear? Now we will write the late finish time also as 20. So now I am going with again changing the ink so that you will get it more clear and clear how you are going to get the value. This is 20. Now going back in direction again, 20 minus 8, 20 minus 8 means it is 12, 20 minus 2 means it is 18, 20 minus 7 it is 13, 13 minus 4 is 9, 13 minus 2 is 11. So we will check it here, which one is minimum. For this I just wrote it because I know that which is minimum one. 12 minus 4 is 8 and 13 minus 4 is 9. So here I'll just write 12 minus 4 is equals to 8 and 13 minus 4 is equals to 9. So minimum one is 8. So I'll write with 8. So sorry for this. This is 8. We will get the value. Minimum one. Similarly for this, minimum one we have to find. 13 minus 2, this one, 13 minus 2 will be 11, and 18 minus 3, 18 minus 3 is 15. So which is the minimum one? The 11 is the minimum one. This will, we will write it as 11. Now on node number 2, again we are getting two back connectivities. So we have to choose the least one. 8 minus 2. 8 minus 2 is equals to 6. And 11 minus 6. 11 minus 6, we are getting 5. Minimum is 5. We are going to write here 5. Now 5 minus 5, we will get 0. So we can see some nodes are having the similar digits. Similar digits means the numbers are same. This one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. Clear? So I can make that as a critical path. I'll show it on the figure itself only first, then I can write it. So on figure I'll write, this is the critical path, double lined. This is the critical path. This is the critical path. We are able to get it. So what is the total duration? 20. Critical part 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. We are going to write it. So now I'll write total duration of the data provided will be equals to 20 days, and using CPM, that is critical path method. So the critical path is 1, 2, 4, 5 and 8. These are the nodes we are getting critical path. So this is what we can say the solution for the second numerical. Let us go for one more numerical. This is the third numerical as considering. Here we have to determine the hourly production of an equipment. So we are going to consider. So in this question, estimate the hourly production of a bulk volume LCM. LCM means loose soil in cubic meter of an backhoe. Is an instrument with a bucket capacity of 0.96 cubic meters that is employed on an excavation of a foundation which is 4 meter deep in hard digging soil. The excavated earth is to be loaded in a waiting dump trucks placed at the swing angle of 75 degree. The expected performance efficiency is 83%. Assume the ideal output of face shovel with given bucket capacity is 150 loose soil in cubic meter LCM. So assume the and list the suitable corrections they have mentioned. So going with the solution part, so these data are also there available in the textbook, the particular data which I have provided. So we have the data as here. Now we can see these are some of the assumptions which are already listed with the provided data. So we can see equipment conversion factor is 1, wherein face shovel, backhoe, dragline and grab, some instruments are there. These are the equipments which are employed. Soil digging factor, this is 1, medium, easy digging 1, medium digging 0.85, hard digging 0.67. Angle of swing is 75 degree, here it is given 75 degrees, and factor of value which we have to use. They have asked us to assume the ideal output of face shovel, though they have given us backhoe. Backhoe is first, second instrument, and face shovel is first one. So this we have to take for one value. And load casting factor, this is how the load can be casted, means where we are going to put it in that way. So cubic meters, that is employed on an excavation of a foundation which is 4 meter deep. So let us start with the solution. Ideal output will be, I am going to take the first factor, the conversion factor, which will be of face shovel. It is 1 multiplied by LCM, that is 150. This value I am going to consider here. This will be, so this will give me 150 LCM ideal output it is. Now going with the correction factor, so moving with correction factor, when I take, so correction factor for this particular instruments we have to consider. So going with the correction factor, what is the correction factor? We can see here in the particular part for digging, which kind of digging it is, hard kind of digging. So how much we have to take? Multiplying factor 0.67. So 0.67 multiplied by 0.8 is open area or restricted area. The multiplying factor one more is there, varies upon the method of casting of load. So here the excavated earth is to be loaded in a waiting dumper, they have mentioned, means we are considering loading in vehicle. So loading in vehicle, open area, not restricted area. So we will take it 0.8. So this is 0.8 multiplied by, how much is the one more factor which we have to consider? For 75 degree of swing, we are having a factor of 1.07, so that is correction factor 1.07. Altogether we will do the calculation of this part. Clear? So we will get one value of this thing, that value we have to use. Correction factor, the calculation will be 0.573 value will be getting. Now what is the performance efficiency, which is how much it is given, already given in the question, performance efficiency 83%, 83 divided by 100, it will come 0.83. this is performance efficiency. Now expected output per hour we have to find. So expected output per hour, we are going to calculate it as ideal output multiplied by correction factor multiplied by performance efficiency. So ideal output is 150, correction factor is 0.573 multiplied by 0.83. so all together when we take and calculate, we get this value as 71.33 LCM loose soil in cubic meter per hour we can get. This is the answer for the value. So they have asked us estimate hourly production. Hourly production is this one, estimated hourly production. Okay, so this was the problem number 3, and one more numerical is there. The numerical is like this. Now this is one example from the given provided data, that is the note. A company has purchased an equipment whose first cost is 1,50,000 with an estimated life of 8 years. Life of 8 years they have given. Clear? Now the estimated salvage value means the depreciation value of the equipment at the end of its lifetime is only 25,000. Only 25,000. Determine the depreciation and book value. Determine the depreciation and the book value of this particular part of problem for a period of 4 years. For the period of 4 years, that is they have given the particular 4 durations or 4 numbers, that is the time duration, using the straight line method of depreciation. So straight line method of depreciation formula we are going to use. So here the direct solutions we will be looking into. So direct solution, because it is a textbook note, so direct solution is like this. They have given us the purchased amount, which is 1,50,000, and the salvage value, final salvaging value, they are asking it for 25,000 after 8 years of work. Now the depreciation at this particular is P minus F divided by N. We will get it as 15,625, and the book value, which will be P minus T into this particular depreciation value, we will be finding it, this value as 87,500. Now as per the particular module, we have completed the required amount of numericals.